All right, shalom, shalom. We're the real Hebrew Israelites coming day in and day out to prophesy the downfall of Babylon the Great, which is America. First off and foremost, all praises, honor, and glory be unto Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem, Makar Kadash. Double honors to thee, all the apostles, a great millstone, and salutations to the elect, wherever you may be. Brother Shapaya coming at you again from GMS Chicago with a quick lesson through the Spirit. And I'm going to hop straight into it because as I've been going into, all right, these former characters of GMS, starting with Nazariah, all right, Inop, all right, and certain other of their followers, you know, just a little bit over half a year ago, they believed in Yahweh Shai. Now they don't. Oh, you know, they had to restudy the scriptures, apparently, all right? So, which the funny thing is, through all these videos we've done about them in the past, if y'all didn't believe in Yahweh Shai, that means what? Y'all was going off on all those scriptures that y'all brought out. What y'all deemed and said, y'all wasn't going off with y'all so-called new doctrine. But now you have another doctrine, all right? You're like a cartwheel. You're a man given to change, all right? Yeah. See, Yahweh Shai was never good enough for you guys, man. All right. So, like I said, you guys don't think you need a mediator? Go up another way. And you're going to find out what's going to happen, man. All right. So, within some of these videos, they use the Apocrypha. All right. Well, did you guys forget about these prophecies in the Apocrypha? All right. 2nd Ezra 7 and 28. For my son, Yahweh Shai, shall be revealed with those that be with him, and they that remain shall rejoice within 400 years. And after these years, all right, which this links up with the Daniel about the Messiah being cut off, all right, and after these years shall my son, Mashiach, die, all right, not sons, all right, and all men shall have life, all right. This is Edris. So maybe y'all don't believe in the books of Ezra no more, all right. And the world shall be turned into the old silent 7 days, like as in former judgments. So no man shall remain, all right. And you know, and it goes into something else, but that's a prophecy right there. Right, it talks about Yahweh Shai, who is Mashiach, right? So, let's go from there. Let's get another one. Second Ezra 2:42. I, Ezra, saw upon the Mount Zion a great people, whom I cannot number. All right, the one third. All right, the elect. All right, the innumerable crowd. All right, starting with the 144. And they all praised the Lord with songs. And in the midst of them was a young man of high stature, taller than all the rest. And upon every one of their heads he set crowns, and was more exalted, which I marveled greatly. So I asked the angel and said, Sir, what are these? And he answered and said unto me, These be they that put off the mortal clothing and put on the immortal, and have confessed the name of Yahweh. Now are they crowned and receive palms. Then I said unto the angel, What young person is this that crowneth them and giveth them palms in their hands? And he answered and said unto me, It is the Son of God. Not the sons of God, not the body of the prophets, not the elect. All right? Mr. ITR, Mr. Nazariah, and the rest of you niggards that believe that. It was funny, me and Nazariah used to always cut the Old Testament only niggas. Now have you fallen into their folly? Brothers, let this be an example of what the Lord could do to you. This is ultimately saying Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai does not fuck with Nazariah. He brought him into the truth just to mark this nigga so he could get one of the harshest judgments ever. The Lord gets down like that, man. He'll give a nigga the wisdom, take the wisdom away, and allow this man to continue to throw up. And now he's to the point where he's denying Yahweh Shai. This is what you should not be, man. Hold on. Let me see if I can get it.
Who came to you first? And you thought that we went to Miyakala? No, Miyakala seen it himself, bro. Don't no grown ass man have a picture of himself on his phone posted up, bro. Butt ass naked. Ain't nobody watching you goofies, man. And it's the last time we gonna ever address you fucking flunkies, man. And we gonna move on, okay? Because I've been getting nothing but complaints from our followers who say stop talking about you goofies. Even though they understand it has to be done, but move on, man. Them niggas is lightweight. And you know what? They tired of even hearing about you goofies. So after this, you get no more clout. You can make all the videos you want, man. Because you ain't gonna push you on Mississippi, Short Circuit, Kazakh, Forest Bump, all you goofy-ass clowns. You make everything you want to make, but your bitch ass ain't going to refute the scriptures they'll be bringing out. Talk about repent. Repent means to look back, to take it back. You niggas just constantly moving forward. Wow, why y'all keep bringing up the jacket? Because you niggas never look back and realize what really transpired, what offenses may have occurred. And I called your ass like a man, Ricard, and talked to you like a man, and you still turned like a bitch.
I'm a witness to it, talk to
you. Goofy, you talk to this man.
Can't tell, though.
You talk to a man that don't want to serve Yahweh.
Do you want to serve Yahweh, sir?
All you doing is this shit in vain. You go out here, you preach venom, and then you send your fucking taxes to Caesar up in New York. On a blank money order. Yeah. Goofy ass niggas. GMS is not the burning bush, you dumb ass nigga. You dumb nigga. I'm sorry, man. Rebuke them sharply. Right, Abba?
Come on.
Right!
Come on.
You hear that?
Right!
Rebuke them! That I can't, what's not gonna happen. You guys gonna fall out. You guys gonna do this. Well, motherfucker, I'm still here. What the fuck you gonna do to me? Old man, Tahar, T-God, Gabor, Aramlad, Jason, you ain't fucking Ricard, you Jason, hoe ass nigga. And Manasseh, shut your punk ass up. Cause you ain't debating nothing. And you lucky mama here now, so I gotta control my language. Hey mama, yo.
It's right here.
Burning bush, man.
Don't be that nigga. Fuck off my screen, nigga. Back to the scriptures. All right. Verse. Forty-six. Barack, yeah. Verse 47. So he answered and said unto me, it is the Son of God whom they have confessed in the world. So to confess the Son of God, you have to know his name, right? Then began I greatly to commend them that stood stiffly for the name of the Lord. Then the angel said unto me, go thy way and tell thy people the manner of things and how great wonders the Lord thy power thou hast seen. So this is something Esdras prophesied it into the people. He prophesied it about Yahweh Shai. Okay? Simply put. Okay? Let's get this. Where's it at? Ooh, here we go. 2 Esdras 12:31. And the lion, which thou sawest rising up out of the wood and roaring and speaking to the eagle and rebuking her for her unrighteousness with all these words which thou hast heard, this is the anointed, Mashiach, which the highest have kept for them and for their wickedness until the end. He shall reprove them and shall upbraid them with their cruelty. For he shall set them before him alive in judgment and shall rebuke them and correct them. All right. So that's, it talks about the anointed, right? Now check this out. Let's get this. Let me get straight to it. Verse 21. The interpretation of the vision shall I show thee. I will open unto thee the thing that thou hast required, whereas thou hast spoken of them that are left behind. This is the interpretation. He that shall endure the peril in the time have kept himself. They that be fallen to danger are such as have works and faith towards the Almighty. Now therefore, they that be left behind are more blessed than they that are dead. This is the meaning of the vision, whereas thou sawest a man coming out of the midst of the sea. The same is he whom the power, the highest, have kept for a great season, which by his own self shall deliver his creature, and he shall order them that are left behind. Let me start that over. The same is he, not the same as them, the same is he whom Yahweh, the highest, have kept for a great season. And Yahweh is keeping Yahweh Shai for a great... It's been a great season. It's been 2,000-some years. All right? Which by his own self shall deliver his creature, and he shall order them that are left behind. This same man. All right? Which all judgment is committed into him, right? And whereas thou sawest that out of his mouth there came a blast of wind, fire, and a storm, and that he held neither sword nor any instrument of war, but that the rushing in of him destroyed the whole multitude that came to subdue him. This is the interpretation. Behold, the days come when the Most High will begin to deliver them that are upon the earth. All right? And this is in the midst of World War III. All right? And he shall come to the establishment of them that dwell upon the earth. And one shall undertake to fight against another, one city against another, one place against another, one people against another, and one realm against another. And the time shall be when these things shall come to pass, and the signs shall happen, which I have showed thee before. And then shall my son be declared. Who's going to be declared? Yahweh Shai, when he cracks those clouds. And what's going to happen after that? Whom thou saw a man ascending. All right? And when all the people heard his voice, every man shall in their own land leave the battle they have one against another. So World War III is going to stop. Verse 34. And the innumerable multitude shall be gathered together as thou sawest them, willing to come and to overcome him by fighting. But he shall stand upon the top of Mount Zion. All right. Now say he was ascending. All right. Not only does this mount represents the government of Israel, but also this enormous chariot. All right, and Zion shall come, and shall be shown to all men. All right, remember Zion came out of heaven, man. New Jerusalem, right, coming down, right, being prepared and built like as thou sawest a grill graven without hands. For this, my son shall rebuke the wicked inventions of those nations, which are their weapons, right? Which for their wicked life are falling into tempest. All right? Yeah, and that's pretty much it. But who is it? Who's that son? Yahweh Shai, once again. Okay? So you cannot just put Yahweh Shai away, man. He's throughout all the scriptures. All of them. All right. Let me see. Mm-hmm. Who is this stone? Daniel 2 and 34. Thou sawest till that a stone was cut out without hands and smote the image upon his feet and iron clay and break them into pieces. All right. Hold on, let me get it. Verse 44, in those days, these kings shall the Yahweh of heaven set up a kingdom, which, now the kingdom's going to be set up, but whose shoulders is it going to be upon? Who's going to have that dominion? All right, go read Daniel 7. All right, go read Isaiah the 9th chapter. All right. Which should never be destroyed. The kingdom should not be left to another people. But it shall break into pieces and consume all nations. All right, the same mountain Ezra was just talking about, right? And it came, and it shall stand forever. For as much as they saw the stone that was cut out of a mountain without hands, and that it break into pieces the iron, brass, clay, silver, and the gold, the great power have made known to the king what shall come to pass hereafter. And the dream is certain, and the interpretation thereof is sure, right? Let me hit 45. Okay. Which, kind of, that's what I just read. All right, who is that stone? That's the same cornerstone that was refused by the builders, man. All right, matter of fact, let me hit this. Check this out. Check this out. 2 Samuel 22:2. And he said, Yahweh is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer. Now check verse 3 out. The power of my rock. In him will I trust. Who's the power of the rock? Who is the rock? All right. It says the God of my rock. In him will I trust. He is my shield, the horn of my salvation, my high tower, my refuge, my savior that saves me from violence. All right? There you go. It could have said the strength of my rock, so on and so forth, but it didn't say that. It said the God, the Elohim of my rock. All right? Which is Yahweh Shai. All right? That's why King David said what? The Lord said unto my Lord. But see, these are things that the Lord took from these niggas, man. All right? Simply put. Mm-hmm. Let me see. Because ultimately, Yahweh is the rock. But he has a rock cut without stones too, that chief cornerstone, which is Yahweh Shai. So, with that, hey, I pray this was edifying through the spirit and power of Yahweh Shai. All right. And I pray, you know, like I said, you brothers, let this be an example of what not to be when you enter into the truth, man. Because this could be the outcome, and the ultimate outcome is death. All right? The ultimate outcome is death. All right? And you know what? And since you guys are still stuck in the Old Testament, what about... get this real quick. Let me find this real quick. Bear with me. Jeremiah 31:16. All right. Jeremiah 31:16. I'll start with 15. Thus saith Yahweh, a voice is heard in Ramah, lamentation, and the bitter reaping. Rahel weeping for her children refused to be comforted for her children because they were not. When did that prophecy come to pass, man? When did that come to pass? Okay. Matter of fact, 31:15, right? 31:15. Let's get it. All right, Ramah Hill. All right. Said a fortified city in Naphtali. Alright. Ramoth Gilead. Alright. So it was in Israel. It was a city in Israel, right? Alright. Rachel, alright. Which is one of the matriarchs of Israel. And it says she was crying, weeping for her children. All right, why is that? When did that prophecy come to pass? All right, that came to pass in the New Testament. Matter of fact, if y'all own Old Testament only, right? When did you guys must still be waiting for? Malachi 4:5. Behold, I will send you as Elijah the prophet before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. First of all, y'all don't believe in reincarnation, so how do you explain this now? These guys don't believe in shit no more, right? All right. So are you guys still waiting for Elijah? That's my question to you. Are you guys still waiting for Elijah? It's ridiculous, man. All right. I forgot how I was writing. Here you go. Numbers 24:17. I shall see him, but now I shall behold him, but not nigh. There should come out a star out of Jacob, and a scepter shall raise out of Israel. Who was that? And shall smite the corners of Moab and destroy the children of Seth. And Edom, all right, And this is what Balaam said, all right? He saw the end of he saw the glory of the nation of Israel, or starting with Yahweh Shai. Edom should be a possession. Seir should be a possessed for his enemies. And Israel should do valiantly. All right? So there you go. To say, hey, that star that came out of Jacob. Okay? Simply put. So listen, like I said, Yahweh Shai is written through all the Old Testament, man. All right? He's in the Apocrypha. No matter which way or how you want to twist it, man. All right? And these guys, hey, they was faithless to begin with, man. And ultimately, they're enemies of the cross, the enemies of HaMashiach, and they're guilty of his blood. So with that, hey, all praises, honor, and glory be unto Yahweh, Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem Makar Kadash. Double honors to thee, elder apostles, a great millstone, salutations to the elect, wherever you may be. Shalom.